Пелевиничу! Алексею Пелевиничу! Алексею Пелевиничу! Надежде Толоконниковой! Надежде Толоконниковой! Надежде Толоконниковой! Мария Алехиной! Мария Алехиной!
Сергей Гривов голодает в тюрьме 40 дней! Сергей Гривов голодает в тюрьме 40 дней!
What is your name, please?
Наталья Пелевайн.
Thanks. Наталья, can you tell me what's going on today here?
Well, there's a protest, and there's quite a few people actually here, even though it's extremely cold. And the protest is to do with the really outrageous imprisonment of the protesters that were arrested on the 6th of May during a protest on Balotne Square. Many people were taken. There was a what authorities believe was a riot. However, it did end up getting messy, but we're not sure who provoked the whole messiness, the whole situation. There were quite a few brutal beatings, etc. Both sides were involved, supposedly. And now, around 13 people are in jail, and they're not even leaders of the opposition. They're just regular activists, many of them young people. Who were arrested that day, who are still in jail 6 months on, and who are facing charges that might end up in jail sentences 6 years or more. So it's a very dire situation, because those people don't believe they're guilty of anything. They have not pleaded guilty. They want to prove their innocence. It's extremely hard to do, because Russian authorities are determined to make this case a political case. For them, it's a political case. For them, it's a way to show the rest of the country, really, that first of all, if you go to those protests, you might end up getting arrested. And secondly, you know, people go to protests are just barbaric, you know, homeless, nothing to do people. Sergei Krivov, actually, is very much a unique case. He's 51 years old. He's a father of two kids, I believe. He has a PhD. He's a professional guy. I know him from other protests that we've conducted.
This guy is not criminal.
He's
never
not criminal.
Been like gangster.
Very
nothing.
Nothing like that. He's very calm, very collected. I know him personally. He's a very sensible guy. I don't believe he would ever be in a situation where he would be aggressive towards anybody, even police officers. I don't believe that's the case. And he certainly doesn't accept his charges. He thinks he's innocent, and he went on hunger strike. And he's been on hunger strike for 35 days.
35 days today.
Today, I believe it's 35 days, maybe 36 already. But that's a really long time. And all he drinks is water with sugar, and that's it. And he obviously lost a lot of weight. He's not feeling very well.
What do you say, this guy? What is his message?
His message is, this is not right. This is,
you know,
his
why
protest.
I ask you, I'm sorry. I ask you, that's why. All world watching Russian TV, but all world think it's true what's going on in Russia.
Well,
but
precisely.
Tell me, what do you want to say this guy now?
Well,
what he feels?
The truth is very hard to get out, because we have very little access to the media, except for the internet, and even that's limited to a degree. He wants to say that this is all a political case, that he's innocent, he did not assault anyone, he should not be on the charges that are put against him, and out of protest, as people do, he went on hunger strike. How long he will remain on hunger strike, we don't know, but obviously it's a very dangerous situation for his health. His family is very worried, and we want to support him, because we want the truth. We want the truth for him. We want the truth for the rest of the people in jail on those charges. And it's very, very hard to get the truth in this country at the moment, because you know, the Kremlin and Putin is determined to keep one line of politics, and that is, it's them against us, and we are in the minority, and we're, you know, we're the losers who know nothing, and who want bad things for their country, and probably work for the U.S. State Department.
Natalia, today it's very cold. I want to ask you last question. Tell me, how you think Russian government, he wants to talk to people from protest? How you think Russian government hurts these people from Russian protest?
Russian government what again?
Want to talk to people from protest.
Do they want to talk to us?
How you think?
I really don't think they want to talk to us. I think they want to ignore us.
All of them, anytime.
I think they want to ignore the whole protest altogether. I don't think they think we are influential enough yet. I don't think our leaders even are influential enough yet. At the same time, just to be on a safe side probably for them, they will continue to pressure the leaders of the opposition. They will continue to start up criminal cases against people such as Navalny and Udaltsov with possible jail sentences. They just want a lockdown on the country. They want to make sure that suddenly our movement doesn't grow, very big, let's say, and becomes a real threat. I don't think they see it as a threat right now, but I think they do know that their position is very unstable. And so if we continue as we do, anything could happen tomorrow. So they do want to keep control, a lid over it. And they will be pretty brutal with us, I think, in the future in terms of protests and in terms of possible criminal charges against many of us. Who knows?
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Appreciate
it. Good luck.
Thank you.